Picture the scene. It's the early 1960s, and across the Atlantic, a musical revolution is brewing with a band called the Beatles. Back in the US, they're still a whisper, a curiosity, not yet the icons they're destined to become. Enter Jack Paar, an American TV legend known for his wit and a keen eye for the next big thing. Paar's show, the Jack Paar Program, was like a cultural telescope, bringing distant stars a little closer to American living rooms. And what does he do? He decides to introduce his audience to the Beatles. This isn't just any TV spot, it's a groundbreaking moment. The Beatles, with their mop-top haircuts and catchy tunes, were already causing a stir in Britain, but in the US, they were virtually unknown. The day the Beatles appeared on Paar's show, American viewers got their first real taste of what was coming. There were no screaming fans yet, no Beatlemania in the streets, just a curious audience and a band from Liverpool on the brink of changing music forever. This appearance was a glimpse into the future, a teaser of the frenzy that would erupt just a few months later when the Beatles made their iconic appearance on The Ed Sullivan Show. Jack Paar didn't just show America a new band, he opened the door to a cultural phenomenon. His show was the first domino to fall in the chain of events that would lead to the Beatles becoming a household name in the US. It's a moment worth remembering, when a legendary host met a soon-to-be legendary band, and together, they made television and music history.
You know, everyone talks about the Beatles, but no one does anything about them. The Beatles are an extraordinary act in England. I think they're the biggest thing in England in 25 years. And actually, the music is rock and roll. Now, we've never, in my 7 years at NBC, ever on The Tonight Show, on this show, ever had a rock and roll act. But I'm interested in the Beatles as a psychological, sociological phenomenon. And I want to show them to you tonight. They're from the toughest part of England. It's Merseyside, on near Liverpool in the dock area. And it's a very tough area where these four nice kids come from. They're kind of witty. Someone said, what's so exciting about living on the docks at Liverpool? He says, just staying alive is exciting in the docks. but they're nice kids, and I'd like to show you now all for the first time what it looks like in an audience in England when the Beatles are about to perform. These guys have these crazy hairdos, and when they wiggle their head and the hair goes, the girls go out of their minds. Does it bother you to realize that in a few years these girls will vote, raise children, and drive cars? I just show you this in case you're going to England and want to have a fun evening. Now here are the Beatles. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you. know you should be glad.
It's nice to know that England has finally risen to our cultural level. Ed Sullivan's going to have the Beatles on live in February, and we only, our interest was just showing a more adult audience that usually follows my work, what's going on in England.
Peace and love.